Hey everybody, thanks for coming by today. We're going to be diagnosing and fixing a Toro Timemaster, is that what it is? 30 inch deck, and or is it a time cutter? I forget. Well, it was burning a lot of oil, suspected a blown head gasket, and I saw a lot of oil being blown through the breather tube back into the carburetor, and just decided to go for it. So this video is about taking off the head, and then also we're going to be taking off the flywheel and repairing the main seal on top of the crankshaft on top of the case. And what else do we do? Reset the valves, okay, and then repair a shroud bolt that holds the shroud on and the nut, how those bolts get stuck to the shroud sometime, and I show how to reinstall those so they don't come out. So that's it. Enjoy the video. Subscribe if you like.
way more satisfying. That's because Metashare works. It has for more than 30 years. It's a community of Christians.
We must invest in that financially. So I hope there's something to the Wall Street Journal reporting. I hope it's true that Elon Musk invests there, because that's the missing piece.
There's so much to go over, but I'm going to go to the Joe Biden Midwest Journal. We still didn't have to.
If the opportunity came up to do one between now and then, is there a sense of wanting to get back on the horse?
I'm on the horse. Where are you, man?
Mr. President, it's always good to talk to you, good to see you. Thank you for making some time for us.
Sometimes come and talk to you about what we should be talking about.
So let's see what's going to happen. I mean, Kamala Harris will probably definitely outgunned when it comes to the problems of the term. I definitely think she's going to have a slot for this country, and I'm not done fighting for it. So I want to give you an example of how the media doesn't get how they lost its credibility by covering for Joe Biden for these years and making Trump out the biggest comeback in maybe political history. And you're bringing up a separation policy, which obviously NBC wants to undermine. Who are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no, it doesn't surprise me because they only have one thing to say because their policies suck. I mean, tens of millions of illegal immigrants have come to this country, tens of thousands of military HMLs from China, Syria, Yemen have come to this country in December. We have 80,000 children who are missing, exploited.
In year one of an administration that lasted 4 years and hasn't been in power in seven.
Exactly.
So, here, quick thing, when it comes to what's happening here with immigration, as a candidate came here legally as a refugee, appreciated the process,
feedback is going on. Once you get a green sheet, ask the class, how do you think about sending it over?
I mean, it's an insult to all of us who've done the best thing we can to follow the laws. My father was so proud of this citizenship that that's the last thing he's had hang over his head before he passed away 2 years ago.
is responsible for the contents of this advertising, not authorized by the Canada Accountants Committee. Conservatives for
Conservatives.com. If you're thinking of selling your home, I'm sure there are two things you want, certainly in the most money, right? Hi, it's Mark Cox, and if you've been listening to me for some time, you know the only agent I trust is Gloria Lee with Your Home Sold Guaranteed Realty. Sam's real estate expert, Todd. We talked a little bit about the YouTube team had earlier in the show. We're sitting with George on from Flower very, very soon. But in the meantime, if you're a business owner here in St. Louis and you need great, I mean exceptional IT support to make sure you're not hacked or you don't have a ransomware attack, you're going to pay for that ransom because no client of Flower is ever paid. And check them out. You're going to want to hire them. Something else set for a little later in this hour. We called an audible early in the show because there is, I don't know if you've even seen this story, there's a story that the Post-Dispatch might have or will have. Jamie Reed, who's the whistleblower from the WashU so-called gender-affirming care clinic, who was
are the NBC suits and assassinations that are about to come with it really bizarre, particularly when you consider that in 2016, Morning Joe, Mika, and Joe Scarborough were huge fans of Donald.
I know, isn't it crazy how much it has turned? And then Jimmy Vance was not a huge fan of Donald Trump in 2016.
Right. Well, yeah, you said in 2016, he's the 24th. Trump will be running for election a third time. Jamie Vance will be his VP, and Morning Joe will be taken off the air because they're afraid of me. Really, might say the aftermath of the assassination attempt regarding Trump is that we've not been high on your bingo list, but that's where we are.
What would you, well, I just spent a fair amount of time with my friend Jeff Fitch, who used to be the chief of police in San Luis County. He's a consultant now, and he's worked a lot of these, even some of the debates we've had here at WashU, the vice presidential debates over the course of the last decade.
Closer to the, I guess, the pessimistic contrarian. So let me throw a little bit of cold water on
you. Well, this is what I have, because the next question was going to be, is the election over? And I don't think the election is quite over. Go ahead.
I don't think the election was over yet. We're not seeing any sign of a major bump yet, which I'm even out of surprise by for Trump. But let me just, here's the cold water thing. And so, as you know, I tend to look down the road in several, spaces ahead and in this chess game. And, okay, so what Trump did was amazing. He looked strong, it was iconic, it was emotional, and all that. He is no longer, Mark, a political. Solely political figure. He is now, to many people, a religious figure because they truly believe he survived.